Canadian women are kind of kinky, they got a lot of fetishes and stuff. Canadian women always want me to talk dirty to them in the bedroom because they've had like some Outlander, like they've been watching too much Outlander, right? And then you have like some like fantasy of like some buff Scottish guy, long hair on a horse, like take them to a castle and then ravage them, right? And then all they get is me, just like, oh, I take you to the basement apartment and there's a fucking your mattress on the floor, right? So I'll close my eyes, you know, right? They always want to talk dirty to me. And I'm just not into it, right? Because I got a lot of stuff going on when I'm having sex, right? I'm trying to maintain a rhythm, trying to keep an erection going, right? There's two voices in my head being like, please don't come, please don't come, please don't come. And the other voice is going like, come already, you pussy, come already, you pussy, come already. I get no time for chit chat, you know? This one girl I met on Tinder, right off the bat, her opening message was, oh, I'm so glad you're Scottish, I have a Scottish guy fetish. I didn't know that was a thing. And by the way, I would never fetish shame anyone, but if you're attracted to a guy who eats porridge, looks like porridge, and smells like porridge, right? Just a big lump, you know what I mean? You're a freak, right? So we started texting, right? We started texting, and we're texting back and forth, and then and suddenly she goes, text me something sexy in your Scottish accent. And I was like, first of all, who texts in an accent? That is bizarre, right? So I just ignored it, right? I thought she was joking, right? 2 minutes later, she texts me, all caps, to know that she was being serious, right? She's like, text me something sexy in your Scottish accent, right? And I didn't know what to do, so I was at work, and I turned to my friend, and I was like, listen, this girl wants me to text something sexy in a Scottish accent, but I don't know what to do, I don't know what to say. And he was like, well, do you think you're ever going to see this girl? And I was like, probably not, right? So he was like, well, why don't you just, we'll just make up something funny, send it to her, you'll never hear from her ever again, right? And I was like, cool. So we came up with this, right? Now, there is some Scottish people in the audience, and I would like to apologize in advance for the thing I said in this text message. I text this girl, I hope one day that I can get to see your haggis. I'm not my finest moment, I'll be honest. And honestly, not quite sure what I meant by it. And I texted it, I threw my phone away, and I turned to my friend, and I was like, well, never hearing from her again, right? 2 minutes later, I get a text message. It goes, is it weird that I'm turned on by this? And in my head, I'm like, yeah, it's fucking weird, you fucking freak. And she replied, I hope I get to blow your bagpipe. And I'm like, that's too much. This is getting too weird. This is getting too weird. I don't like it. But I wasn't thinking straight, right? I was like, in my head, I should not meet this girl. But my penis was like, meet this girl. This is for sure. You're getting laid for sure. Right? My penis always wins. So like, I met up with this girl. I met up with this girl. We had the first date. We had sex. We're having sex. And as we're having sex, she said to me, talk dirty to me in your Scottish accent, right? And as we've discussed, I don't like talking dirty, right? And then, so I ignored it, just hoping that it would go away somehow, right? And then she did it again, but this time it was like the text message, she got really angry. She's like, talk dirty to me in your Scottish accent, right? And I knew she meant business because her vagina tightened, but not like in a hot way, like as if my dick was in a vice, you know, like a UFC fighter getting choked out, you know, trying to tap but not being released. That's what it was like. And I was worried, I didn't know what to do, so I said to her, I said the unsexiest thing you can ever say to a woman while you're having sex. I said, I don't know what to say. And she said, tell me you want to touch my haggis. And I forgot about that text message. I had no idea what she's talking about. Before I had a minute to even reply, she did it again. She goes, tell me you want to touch my haggis. Grab my finger and stuff it up her arsehole, guys, right? Unlooped. No consent. Up to the second knuckle. Which is two knuckles too many. And I screamed. I was like, ah! And she thought I was turned on. She was like, oh! And then she came. My dick went soft, but my finger was still hard because it was still inside her bum, guys. It was really weird. I've been so traumatized by that moment for the rest of my life, right? And if you don't know why that's dramatic, right? The national dish of Scotland is a haggis. And she referred to her arsehole as a haggis. That is cultural appropriation, guys. I have never enjoyed Burns Night ever since.
Oh my God.
Sometimes I can feel my finger twitch when I think about it. So gross. Moving on.